think as a man that you have a longer, you know, orgasm than a woman.
But women can have like multiple orgasms, right?
Yeah, you can have multiple.
Like back to back, whereas
but how long are they lasting? Yeah, men can only have the one at a time. Every 15 minutes. Welcome back to the Chatterbox Toronto.
Hey.
I always say that in such a sing-songy voice. So annoying.
Yes, we're getting lit. We're getting lit in the Chatterbox Toronto.
Yes, we are getting lit, okay? And I do have Miss G back again today. Say hi in the comments, guys. Say
love the show. I gotta keep coming back.
Yes, one of my favorite guests. Okay. So we're gonna get right into the juicy topics just like we usually do. And I have the first one today. The first one is my boyfriend of 10 months. So 10 months, keep that in
mind. That's so specific. 10
I know.
Months. So
my boyfriend of 10 you. Months recently got really drunk after a party, and on the way home during an argument, he spit in my face and pulled my, I'm saying this so loud because I can't believe this.
What?
He spit in my face and pulled my hair. He says that he's really sorry and he promises not to do it again. She puts that he cried. Okay, like that means anything. He has never hit me before. Is this a deal breaker?
Yes.
Why are you putting that he cried? Who cares? Like, he pulled your hair and spit in your damn face.
The first time, any form of aggression, run.
That's a red, a huge red flag. Like, yeah. He physically.
It doesn't matter if they're sober or drunk. They can't blame the alcohol because it's not like they're going to stop drinking after that. Like, they might get drunk again and do the same thing.
Sometimes alcohol brings out your true colors. Like,
that is true.
What? He spit in your face?
Yeah, no.
I can't. Okay, no, pulling your hair, of course, violence. Just as horrible. But spitting your face to me is like the ultimate disrespect. Like, he hawked up his saliva and spit it in your face.
Ew. That's nasty.
This is your man who's supposed to love you. Okay, 10 months, I don't know, but
it don't matter. Like, even if it wasn't your man, even as a friend, he shouldn't be doing that.
He needs to be cut out your life, no matter who he is.
I don't know.
He's manipulating you with the crying. I don't care if how sorry he is. Even if he's not manipulating you and he's really sorry, goodbye. Like, go find another girl because I can't trust you. Now I'm going to be scared anytime we argue or you get drunk that this could be a possibility. Boy, goodbye.
Or some people are like, oh, this is a one-time.
That's
me,
what she said.
She
said he's never hit me again. He's never hit me before.
I do not take any chances. So
in
the,
10
first
months,
sign the first sign of aggression like that.
Yeah,
and it doesn't matter if you're drunk because you're probably gonna be drunk again another time. Like, you guys are gonna go out, like, it can happen again.
He got really drunk.
That's your first signal.
So I'm picturing this. You guys are in the car and he pulls your hair, he spits in your face and then pulls your hair. So he did two forms of acts of aggression. That's even worse. Like, he continued. So he spit in your face and didn't feel bad, and then he decided to pull your hair after that.
That's too much. No.
He promises not to do it again and he cried. Girl, we don't care.
Crocodile tears.
We don't care.
We're not falling for that.
And in 10 months, he's never hit you before. Okay, so and?
That's so
even
short,
10
too.
Years,
that's
and he's
the
never
early stages of relationship. 10
yeah.
Months. Yeah, no, I say no, right?
This is a deal breaker 100% to me. Like, no. Even if he's done this after 10 years of being together, like, for me, I don't care. Goodbye. Because now you're changed.
Don't take
chances
with that.
Yeah, your life is important.
That's
like, he could kill you the next
aggression.
Time. What if he opened the door and pushed your ass out of the car while you was driving?
Yeah.
Like, it could have gone anywhere. Or he punched in your throat and you, like, just passed out. Like, he could have hurt you horribly, even though this probably hurt. Like, it doesn't matter. Whatever, anything physical towards you is not acceptable.
You let him go and tell him to seek some counseling or something. At least, you know, try to offer some help, but just
you don't have to.
I ain't trying to be. I would still offer some help. Like, I'm not gonna
have to.
You.
I get what you're saying,
but
you're a nice person.
You know, just try to help. You know yourself.
You don't
and
have to do shit except
that.
Good at
deal with that aggression.
Okay, it's nice for you to offer help or whatever, but if you don't, that's his business. Like, bye. Like, you don't have to offer any sort of anything to this person who has physically done this to you. Okay. And
well, the next question, are you gonna be calling the police and pressing charges?
Like, what's gonna happen past this? Because what if now he, like, you don't know with this type of person, you don't know what it could lead to. He might want to stalk you, he might want to, you don't know. Like, girl,
I'd say first signs of that form of aggression, no.
Even if you yell at me too hard, like, bye. Because okay, I'm not dealing with it.
I don't know about the yelling, because people argue, come on.
No, of course, yelling. I'm saying yell at me too hard. Like, you're yelling and your spit is flying in my face, and you're like, in my face. Spit it, like, no.
But long, for me, we can argue like that, as long as you don't touch me and try to hit me or, no, you know?
Mm-mm. Because even arguments.
I can argue,
because
I'm going to be giving it right back to you. I'll be all up in your
That's
face
fine, but
too.
If the guy is like.
Yeah, but you don't hit me.
No, I can't. And certain things as well as, like, arguing, too, with, like, calling certain names. Like, I'm very low tolerance when it comes to a lot of things. Like, I just don't tolerate a lot. So you're not gonna be calling me bitches and hoes and all this stuff while we arguing or fuck you.
You don't tolerate no disrespect.
I don't tolerate those types of things. So yeah, I'm not saying it's horrible. It's horrible to accept it. I'm sorry. It's horrible to accept it, but it doesn't mean that you should break up with
somebody.
There's
different levels.
Yelling.
Cause if we're both doing that, you call them. You shouldn't be disrespecting me, calling me anything, but. If it's not
if that's your
I'm calling you, like, some people can argue like that and it's cool. This is how
that's
you
true.
Argue.
That's true, because right? It depends on your relationship. Like,
yeah.
The physical thing is a definite no-no on
exactly.
both parts, even if you're both hitting each other.
Exactly.
No.
But the verbal, it depends if it's verbal abuse or, like, an argument. Like, some people are verbally abusing people, like, putting them down, telling them, like, just bringing down their whole...
Yeah, like calling you stupid bitch.
Yeah,
oh, we're done.
That kind of
like,
stuff, no. But if it's arguing and it's, like, in...
And if you guys
both
are,
you are going back and forth with your insult, then you get it. Just like
but even if you guys are both going back and forth, there's a level to where it's an unhealthy relationship.
There's a limit to it.
Like, you cannot be cussing each other out like that, like, in that sense. Like,
yeah.
You can argue and be like, what the fuck, dude? But not directing it towards me like you're saying, fuck you, and all this, like, back and forth. Like, that's not healthy. Y'all
it's
need
not,
some relationship therapy if that's what's going on.
Well, if you're having, if that's something that's happening on a regular, then definitely.
Yeah.
Like.
One
you know,
blowout.
Maybe you guys don't really argue, but there's something, you know?
You have, like, a blowout type
thing. Yeah, you have a blowout, and that's it. After that, it's fine, and you don't really have one again. But if it's people who are constantly arguing, you're constantly insulting each other, then obviously the relationship is not working.
Yeah, and especially if it's one-sided, like, no. You can't have somebody calling you down every day or, like, talking to you like that every time you guys argue, and you're silent.
Yeah.
That's abuse. Like, that's when it becomes abuse.
Yeah.
So
that's when...
There's a lot of different things that can make your relationship so unhealthy and... A lot of people are going through this and they're living like this and
unfortunately,
they're just
and then they're enduring it, which is the sad part.
Yeah, but this is a hell no. If you were my sister, my daughter, something like that, like, girl, I'd be telling you the same. Like, get run. Like, this is a no-no. Never accept this. He spit in your face and he pulled your hair. Like, oh my god, I can't, girl. I want to give you a hug because the fact that you're saying he cried, he's never hit you before, it's like you're kind of like defending it a little bit, like, well, he hasn't done this, or no, what he did is 100% wrong, and yes, it's a deal breaker.
Yeah.
Like, that's how I see it.
No way.
I don't think there's anything else to say about this except
it's self-explanatory.
We're praying for you. I hope that you really get out of this and don't let nobody treat
comment
you
below
way,
some
ever.
Words of encouragement to
to this lady
sending this question
because please you guys comment below, and if you disagree, I want to hear why you disagree and why you think that this shouldn't be a deal breaker.
Yeah, because some people don't let it go that easy. They're like, oh, it's one time, give him a chance
but
to see if he doesn't do
this
it again.
This says 10 months, okay? 10 months. That's not a long time. Life is very,
well,
very
some people
short.
Believe in second chances.
He's spitting in your face.
Like, okay, it happened once.
Chance.
So maybe be like, if it happens again, like one
but that's
more
how
time,
a lot of women die. That's how a lot of women get killed.
So that's the thing, right?
If I'm gonna be to the extreme, that's how a lot of women get killed.
Yeah.
You give a second chance to an abuser and he fucking kills you the next time. Like,
exactly.
Just please get out of this relationship. Find somebody who's gonna love you, love on you, and know how to argue with you in a healthy relationship, in a healthy way, sorry.
Mm-hmm.
Because this is not, there's so many fish in the
or
sea.
Or tell us, I don't know, but
like, you don't need to accept that. You can be nice like Miss G and you can help him get some help, you know, if you really want.
I'll just refer him to, okay, go there. I'm not fucking with you anymore, but call this number.
You
know, get some help.
You can definitely do that if you want. I want to hear from you guys, though, who disagree especially. And for those of you who agree with us, like she said, comment below with some words of encouragement to help this girl push through and move on. And if you've been in an abusive situation, I want to hear from you, too. Like, if you have a story that you want to tell that could help other women to understand how important it is not to accept abuse from anybody in any shape or form, friends, family, it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
It's not tolerated. Like, nobody should be physically hurting
Never
you.
Never tolerate
ever.
That disrespect.
Or emotionally abusing you, things like that. So, it's a no-no. It's a hell no. Okay? Comment below.
Oh, that's like, right. Like, Drop a beat. Let me
comment below. Yeah, Chatter Master Shanti coming to you soon. Album coming to you soon.
Yeah.
But yeah, comment below. Comment below. Comment below. I want to hear from you guys. And yeah, wish you all the best whoever wrote this question.
Yes.
Okay. And I hope you're okay. Like, I hope you're okay. Because that can actually emotionally damage you.
Yeah, it's traumatizing. What did I do wrong?
Some girls are not so strong, and they'll just be thinking like, "What is it about me that he did that?" Like, no, he's a fucked up person. It's nothing to do with you. Okay, moving on.
Yeah, moving on.
That is touched my heart. Yeah. Like, I feel so bad for this person. Okay, so moving on to the next question. My partner has never introduced me to his 3 kids.
Okay. That's a lot of kids.
Yeah, it is. So that means it's not your kid. It's 3 kids. So we are an older couple. So I'm 45 and he's 48.
Okay.
Okay, so you're older. We've been dating for 2 years now. He gets irritated when I bring up the subject. What should I think?
About when is he going to introduce her?
About the fact that he gets irritated when she brings up the subject about meeting his 3 kids. Mm-hmm. So she's never met them. Well.
And they've been dating 2 years?
Yeah. You know what? Okay, I'm just going to start it off. Sorry. I'm going to start it off by saying this is like a question we had, I think, in season one where it said, like, my partner has never introduced me to their parents. Okay. Mm-hmm. Some people have different relationships with their people, so you don't really know what's going on. But I do think that if you've been together for 2 years, he should explain that. Like, maybe I don't get along with them. I don't have a relationship with them, which is sad.
Okay, I guess this is an older couple, so his kids are grown.
They're more older kids, right?
Okay, yeah, that makes sense.
So, I mean, I think it's more of, like, on his part, he should tell you why, like, it's so that you can just let it go. But if he's told you why and he just doesn't want you and he gets, like, and you keep asking, I get that.
Yeah, it will get annoying if he already told you no. Oh, I guess we don't know the situation.
We don't know
why.
So we're speculating again.
Or why not, but yeah.
I don't know, I just...
Well, if it's a situation where he says he's not close to his kids or they're not close to him or they don't...
Like, is he seeing his kids and he just doesn't want you to see
them? Yeah, that's when it's kind of like, okay, that's when you got to give the side eye. Like, it's been 2 years.
What's wrong with me? Like, why can't I
meet your kids? That makes me feel like, okay, you're not good enough to meet your kids, right? You're good enough to meet your kids. So then what are we doing? Because we've been there for 2 years. That's a serious relationship.
Like, if you guys plan to get married, are the kids going
to
be at the wedding?
I would think your kids need to know me because I'm going to have to build a relationship with them.
And awesome, I want to know so many things, like, how is he with his other family members? Is he close with anybody? I mean, does he see them on his own time? Do you guys ever have family gatherings and are they not there? Or why haven't, because you said introduced, so maybe you've seen them around, but you haven't been actually introduced as this is my new, this is my girlfriend or my whatever.
I think we need more details about this question.
Yeah, I don't know what you should think is you need to talk to your man. You need to talk to him and see what, or you need to write us again.
Well, she said she'd been talking and he's annoyed, so what's she supposed to do now?
He gets irritated when you bring up the subject, but why? Is it because you've already told him? I mean, you've already asked him, he's already explained to you, like, I'm not cool with them, I don't have a close relationship with them, they're bad kids, so, they're annoying, whatever it is.
So let's give them advice in both situations. So if it's the first situation where he's saying he already explained to her why,
then you need to leave the man alone. Okay. If you don't want to be with a man that's not close with his kids, then you need to leave him. You need to leave him alone if he already explained to you why it is that he's not close with them or doesn't introduce you to them.
But even with the why, I think it's only why if he says they're not close to them. If his why is like, oh, I'm just not ready, then like, okay, it's been 2 years, like, because there could be different reasons.
Yeah, if you're just not ready, like, Mr. Man, pull up your pants. Yeah. You're 48. Like, you need to be ready. Your kids are grown. They'll be okay with it. She's not a younger woman. Because that was what I was thinking. Like, they're close in age. So 45 and 48 is not too different. So
I don't get, especially if they're grown, like, what's the big deal? I understand when people have younger kids, like, you don't want to, early in a relationship, you don't want to
just introduce
them so early. Because if they're the last, like, you don't want to be introducing your kids to all these different women or all these different men that you're dating, but you're grown and your kids are probably, well, it could be young too, who knows, like,
even if they were, well, true, they could be really young. You could have just got out of a relationship in 2 years before and they just got with her.
So we don't know the age of the kids matter. Maybe the issue with the mother for children, maybe there's some sort of drama there that he doesn't want to
even,
it can be
so many things.
So I guess the find out why, but if you already know why, then you decide if that why is a good enough reason
good
to
enough for you.
Stay with him or not.
Yeah, because for obviously if he's irritated, it's touchy for him and he doesn't.
Yeah, so he doesn't, if he told you why, but you're trying to be like, oh, well, it's not a big deal. Let me just see. You already told, if he's not comfortable with it, you already try to push a bit. Because sometimes people are like, oh, I don't really. But maybe as his partner, she's trying to go, oh, well, it might not be that bad. Let's just try and, you know? But if you try that he's still not with it, then you either let it go, or if it's that important to you, then maybe you can't be with him if he won't. You can't build a relationship with his kids. Like, that's what you have to decide, I think.
Yeah, like, yeah. And maybe, yeah, I don't know. This is all a conversation because I'm just like thinking maybe.
There's different scenarios. Like, you don't know. It's not clear enough.
You can write us again. I'll accept the question again with more detail, okay? Yeah. Because I really want to be able to help you answer what you should think, but it's hard to know what you should think if I don't know what's really going on and, you know, how he really feels about this and what the reasons are.
Yeah.
I mean, maybe...
We need more details.
Maybe you can meet the kids on your own. Maybe...
No, you're not going to go behind his back.
Behind his back. Maybe he doesn't want to be... Maybe he doesn't want to have a relationship with them. Maybe he would allow...
That doesn't make sense, no. If he can't have a relationship with them, you can. Like, that don't make sense. How are you going to friend up his kids and he can't even talk to his
it's
kids?
It's true, but I'm sure there's relationships out there like that. Maybe she just wants to feel like she...
Or it might just... Maybe a simple introduction might just be what it is.
Yeah.
Not like you want to be like, oh, come hang
buddy with buddy
us,
with
you
know? Them.
But it's a simple introduction. But if he can't even do that, there has to be a reason behind it. Maybe that he doesn't have a relationship with them. Maybe the kids don't really know it. Maybe like... You know, because
he was
mother,
a deadbeat
he wasn't
father.
In their life, so, you
maybe
know.
Maybe he was a deadbeat and he doesn't want his kids to tell you, like, the truth about him. Like, maybe he
that
could
know.
Be
it too.
Could be so many things. And if that's the case, like, that's sad.
Or he doesn't want
to
show that, oh, my kids don't know me. So you might look at him different, like, what? Like, you have three kids and you don't take care of them. Or
yeah, because, okay, just to trail off of this topic onto kind of a little bit of the same, is, like, if you were dating a guy and he wasn't taking care of his kids or wasn't, okay, she's already shaking. That's how I feel. Like, you cannot be with me and have kids and you're not taking care of those kids or in their life in some way or trying to be in their life if you're not in their life.
Yeah, or you tell me, like, if it's the issue where the mother is you want to, but the mother's preventing you, like, that and that, like, you have
But you're
no
still
choice.
Trying, like, through
yeah,
courts,
you're trying,
through
exactly.
whatever it is, like, you're sending, you're trying to be there.
Yeah.
Whether you're just sending financially you're there, like, whatever it is, like, as long as I know you physically
even,
want to be there,
well,
you're
but
trying.
But even then, if you have any sort of baby mama drama, I'm sorry, I can't.
It's already an issue.
It's already a no.
But yeah, like, if you have kids, I would hope that you're in their life
yes.
in some way or trying to be. Because I can't just have somebody that's like, oh, well, the mom don't care. I don't care then because she don't know. No.
You gotta fight for your
deal.
Kids.
That's too much drama.
Fight for your kids. Like Tyrese, he was fighting for his daughter.
Yes, fight.
What more
well,
do you want from me? That's what you should be doing.
Tyrese, I can't. Oh my god. No, I felt bad for Tyrese in that little moment for a minute. But then he pushed it a little too far. I was like, oh my god, he's on social
media. Well, he wanted. He got what he wanted.
But he did. He really. Yeah.
See, when you fight, you can have a positive.
Yeah, even if you have to go on social media and make a
PSA. Do what you gotta do.
Get about your kids. But it proves that you love your kids and you really want them because you know Tyrese loves his daughter. Like, you know that out of everything.
Exactly.
I made it sound
like
a fool.
So if you have that situation where the mother is trying to prevent you from seeing kids, you gotta fight.
Yeah, you gotta fight, man. Your kids are, like, that's an extension of you. Like, fight for your kids, you know? So, I think Miss Lady, whoever wrote me this, Miss 45-year-old, send me another question with more details so we can get back on this topic and really help you out. Because I want to help you figure out what you should think. Like you asked.
Yeah, depending. Do you know why?
Yeah.
And if you do, what is the why reason he's giving you? Or if you don't know why, then
ask
find
why.
Out why.
Exactly. Exactly, because there's a lot of answers we could have for this.
And
comment below if you've been in a situation with baby mama drama or with a man who has kids or a woman who has kids and they're not around them and they haven't introduced
them. Or if you're somebody who has kids but you haven't introduced them to your partner yet.
And why? What
are your
reasons? Obviously, aside from my child is young and I don't want to in and out, people in and out. Aside from that.
If it's been more than a year and you haven't introduced them, why are you not?
Mm-hmm. And what do you guys think is the appropriate length of time to be in a relationship then to introduce your kids? Like, how long do you think is appropriate?
Because I think it depends.
Because some women are dating every 2 months or 3 months and their child is calling them daddy.
That's
so
a bit quick, but
that's another topic.
Yeah, that's another topic.
But yeah, and that's not healthy. But definitely just comment below if you've had any of these scenarios or situations. I want to hear from you what you think. And if you agree or disagree with our advice that we were able to give for
what
this topic.
What we could give with the information we had. Yeah.
The scenarios we
let
made up.
Let us know.
Yeah, let us know. All right, guys, we're going to get into the end of the show where I share a juicy sex fact slash bizarre statistic, whatever you want to call it.
Something my sip to get
weird
ready.
About sex or crazy. Yes, you know we always gotta take a sip before we start this segment.
Yes,
so
yes.
Okay, so this one is finally something different. Okay. The average female orgasm lasts 20 seconds longer. Ooh. So 14 seconds longer than the male orgasm.
Okay.
That's not that long, girl. Just a second.
Well, then how long is the, what is the regular
the
time?
The male is 14 seconds. Oh, sorry.
It says 14 seconds 14 longer, seconds but what is longer. The regular time for a male?
So if it's 14, so 20 minus 14, that's okay. The male there. Orgasms are.
Oh, like the male for.
Yeah, so it's 20 seconds longer, 14 seconds longer than the male, so it's just 14 seconds longer.
But what is the male, like, regular orgasm length?
Is so it would be. So wouldn't it be.
Man, we're confused.
We are confused.
Okay, all we know is that women get it longer
women,
than men.
But I kind of already knew that. I don't think I needed statistics. Like, maybe they're jerking all like all over the place for way longer than a man. Like, a man's just like, bloop, and they're done. Like, you know? And that's just my experience. Because I don't know. I don't know. I've never really seen a man, like, have an orgasm that lasted, like, where I'm like, okay, he's still going, like. No, it was usually within a quick time.
Okay, that's a fun fact to know.
Yeah, that is a fun fact. I mean, comment below if you think as a man that you have a longer, you know, orgasm than a woman.
But women can have like multiple orgasms, right?
Yeah, you can have multiple.
Like back to back, whereas
but how long are they lasting? Yeah, men can only have the one at a time, every 15 minutes or 12 minutes or whatever it is.
Yeah.
Like we can probably have more quicker, like back to back, than a man. But yeah. The length of time that you are actually in paradise. Enjoying
okay, when you're in heaven,
like your eyes are gone back, toes curled, you know, your toes are like,
you got the claw toes
ripping up the sheets and shit.
Oh, wow!
So, yeah, so I guess that's a fun thing
okay,
to know.
Fun fact to know
next time you're a girl on top of your girl or behind your girl, whatever it is, you can count.
You're gonna put a timer on. You're gonna pull out the phone and be like, let me just see.
And if you ever do that, comment below because I want to know if it's true or not.
Oh, and I want to know how do they do these studies? Like, how do they find this stuff out? Like, this have, like, you know?
I know. So, this is gonna be the end of the show. I hope you like that bizarre sex fact or statistic, whatever you want to call it. If you guys have any crazy, fun sex facts, weird, bizarre, anything like that that has to do with sex or relationships, comment below so I can share them on the show or send them in my DMs on one of my social media below.
Slide into the DMs.
And I'm going to do what I usually do and share Miss G's information somewhere here below. So make sure you check her out because, you know, I say it all the time. She has so much going on. She's about to get her YouTube channel up and popping.
It's
going to
be popping again. It's kind of dead now, but it'll be on and popping.
It will be with some lifestyle stuff where she travels and shows y'all the world.
Yes.
And then she also has her blog, her podcast, her Instagram, Stylemmas, where she shows off different styles.
Different style stuff.
You know, that events, you guys can choose from.
If you're in Toronto, check out the events.
Yes, she always shares events. So definitely, definitely check her out below. Not only will her information be linked here, it will also be in the description box below. And thanks again for coming.
Thanks for having me.
I know I love having you, girl.
So it's all fun. Right.
Thank you. And before I let you guys go, make sure you like, subscribe, share, comment, everything this video, okay? Do everything to this video.
Yes.
Everything good except thumbs down. Thumbs up.
Only. Thumbs up.
Thumbs up, thumbs up, thumbs up.
Yes.
All right, guys. Until next time, this was the Chatterbox Toronto. Bye.